second version of my cast interviews for the movie Toy Story 4 Bo, I got choked up. Not surprising because you've got old favorites Woody, Buzz Lightyear, Bo returns. I don't know what you've been doing for the past couple of years, but clearly working out is one of them. There's a lot of action. We all get to sit down with these actors and actresses who voice these great characters. Take a look.
Ducky.
What?
They're making another Toy Story movie.
No! I thought those movies were done, dog. They made three movies.
I read that the most nerve-wracking thing for you was pitching Tom and Tim the idea.
Yeah.
When did you know that you had them?
It was nerve-wracking because they're incredible, and I respect them so much, and they know the characters in the world. They've been doing this for 25 years. But when we were pitching to Tom, it was the moment where Bonnie is in the classroom before she's even made Forky. It's just I was, got to that point. And he went, "All right, you got me. Okay, all right." And then with Tim, we got to the entire pitch and to the end. He went, "What? Come on, really? Okay, all right." So it was he had
reactions.
Different reaction. Yeah. He had to really think about this. Go, man, okay. And then he fell in love with it.
No time to explain. Attack!
I was at the press conference yesterday. I was surprised at how emotional Tim Allen has been through this whole process.
Yes. Yeah.
He talked very openly about that. He talked about, you know, going through loss in his life, and this movie really affected him. Do you think more so than the other ones?
I think so. I mean, just the history of it, when you think about it being almost 25 years, that's a big part of his life, and this character has been so important to him. And the world.
Yeah, and I will say that the last recording session with him was pretty emotional for all of us, you know? Yeah. Just sort of kind of going, we just read the last line.
Yeah,
and
we knew we needed
okay.
to mark that moment with Tom and with Tim because it really was the special day, those last sessions.
And everybody in the room could feel it. We could see like, okay, everybody grew up with this character, these movies, and you could just feel the weight of it.
Hey, up here, Astro Boy.
I relate too much to it. That's why I'm having too much trouble with this now. I don't even relate to it. There's no difference, except I don't have a spacesuit.
If you joined us for one of the many lunches we've had where we just sit around and lose all sense of time and space as we're sitting at a restaurant somewhere, it is Woody and Buzz arguing and agreeing and laughing exactly as they do.
What do you think it is?
Unfortunately, we never get to record together because they should just bring microphones to our lunches and they'd have...
I often agree.
They'd have four or five Toy Story movies right there.
You're Bonnie's toy. You are going to help create happy memories that will last for the rest of her life.
Huh? What?
Woody faces his worst nightmare, and that is another toy that is appreciated by Bonnie. Woody's always got to explain the rules of the room and the ground plan and everybody what everybody's responsibilities are. And he takes these very way too seriously, I think. It's a burden for Woody, but he's always dealing with what is best for either Andy in the early films or in this case now Bonnie.
Everyone, I want you to meet Forky.
I have to start with this. At the park last night, I'm not kidding you, had a total meltdown.
Oh,
I feel
come
like
on.
He is not only in character, but he is channeling Forky.
Oh, that
How
is
adorable
precious.
Is that?
Precious, bless. I think his shoes are Forky too.
But is it sinking in when you see stuff like this?
It comes in stages where I'm, because like even yesterday when we were doing this press conference with Tom and Tim and Annie, and there's a part of me that's like, oh, so they haven't made a mistake? Like they did mean for me to be in this. And then I see that and someone's like, yeah, that you voiced that character. You're like, what? Really? Yeah. You know, it kind of comes in these waves of, and I feel very much like Forky that way. We're both very overwhelmed.
Right.
We both have the imposter theory. We're like, I don't think I'm supposed to be here. And so it's just kind of, we're kind of connected that way.
Woody?
Why am I alive? You are a toy. You belong to Bonnie.
He wants to go back to the trash.
Yeah,
just
yeah,
please
yeah.
get me out of here. What was the last time you felt the need, and don't say this interview, the last time you felt the need to just escape?
That happens often where you're just kind of like, okay, I got to check out. But I love that he's just so kind of like, listen, I was made for chili, and then I got to like, this is my place. I got to go to the trash. And Woody, of course, you know, wonderful Woody is like, no, you have a greater purpose than that. You have value. And on like a meta place, you know, if anybody feels that they're just made for that, you know, they have value. They have a greater purpose. Like, what a great message. Of course, Pixar, like, you know, rings out the emotions.
Open your eyes, Woody. There's plenty of kids out there. Sometimes change can be good.
At the end of it, my nephew goes, Aunt T-Bone, are you crying? I'm like, what if I am?
Yeah, exactly.
Toby, deal with it. You know, when did you know that this was your place? This whole acting thing, when did you know?
Good question. Honestly, that also came in stages because I studied journalism in college. And I'd always done it in high school, and I was like, you know what? After college, I was like, I'm gonna dip my toe back into acting to see what happens. Moved to New York in 95. And then, you know, the more that maybe I got gigs that I could, you know, could give me the income I needed, and I could maybe not do 1,000 different jobs on the side, then I was like, well, maybe this could be the path for me.
Duke Caboom, Canada's greatest stuntman.
I wasn't prepared for how funny Keanu Reeves was.
Yeah, I don't think anybody is.
Oh my gosh, and I heard that the poses were all his idea because he does these crazy, hilarious poses.
Yes, we invited him over to the studio. He wanted to hear more about the movie, and he immediately wanted to dig deep into who this character is which was great.
Yeah, it was amazing. He was asked questions like, does he love Rajan? Does he hate Rajan? They just really kind of... amazing character questions, and we kind of brainstormed the character right there, and he was really getting into it, and to the point where he stood up on the table and went, huh, 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 and there's people in Pixar going, is that Keanu Reeves?
Right. Hold on. Your co-star, I just saw him in an action-packed film called John Wick, but talk about action. Your character, Bo, goes through a lot of action, has a lot of great action sequences. Your training routine, 6 months training?
You know, to get in that kind of shape, wow, it was grueling. And, you know, I do another show, too, so it was really, was doing double duty there.
Hey, nice find, girls.
I can't imagine what it was like for you when you found out they wanted to bring her back in this way, because I was thrilled. So what was that day like for you?
Oh, I was so happy about that because I love her. And I was delighted to hear they were doing another one and delighted to hear that I would have a new and expanded role in it. So it was a good day.
I am not a toy. I'm a spork.
He's very simple. I mean, she creates him in a kindergarten class.
Yes.
I find the older I get, the simplest things bring me so much joy.
It does.
What's the simplest thing nowadays that brings you a ton of joy, but it's really simple?
I'm not like seeing photos like that. Yeah. Little kids just, ugh.
Babies
laughing, forget about it.
Right.
I watch YouTube, like Ellen taking somebody through a haunted house, makes me cackle.
Right.
Soldiers coming home, makes me cry hard. You know, so it's like, even just kind of, you know, taking my daughter and I are practically mall walkers. We walk around, the mall a lot. That gives me so much joy, going to the food court. And actually being with friends with history gives me a lot of joy. Just the simple, I mean, I'd rather hang with friends that I've known for decades than go on some kind of massive, you know, European tour or something like that.
What's the simplest thing that's bringing you guys such joy?
My kids. Just seeing, like, watching my kids laugh here at Disney World, it's makes me so happy.
Yeah. It's amazing to finally be able to share the film with them, right? 4 or 5 years we've been working on this, but it's not till within the last few weeks we've gotten to share it with them and see their reaction to it, and that's been pretty special.
Is that a whisper?
I started in this franchise 24 years ago, so we've all been in it, us OG people, the long haul, but I'm thrilled, and I personally hope there's more.
So do I, and I think you will too when you see it.
If you should ever leave me.
You know, you've handled this lost toy life better than I could.
You get to do some work with Tom in this, some of the voice work, and he says, listening to you is like a little bit of pudding. How do you describe listening to him?
Oh. Well, he's just, he's so beloved and so deserving of that. You know, he's just the kindest, most lovely man. And it's just a dream to work opposite him. because of course his heart and spirit are so big. He brings everything to his work, and so it makes everybody else bring everything they got to it, and it's just it's wonderful to be in the room with him.
Well, it's a pleasure being in this room with you.
Everything's gonna be okay.
Giveaways, we'll see you at the movies. You don't have a family, do you? This is really so good. I'm glad you're here.